Most people don't like to use Gutenberg. But let's face it, Gutenberg is quite fast to load. So if you're looking for performances and also all the features of a page builder, let me introduce you to Gutenkit. So Gutenkit is a blog plugin that brings a page builder experience into Gutenberg. So now you can build complex layout with containers, tabs, accordions, and you get access to 85 very useful blocks and modules. And now you can even design dynamic websites with the query loop builder, create a mega menu within minutes for better site navigation. You'll get direct access to 50 plus blocks and 18 modules and more already in the pipeline, including parallax effect, one page scroll, off canvas menus, glass morphism, and tons of new features. And you can also build websites in minutes with 500 plus ready-made templates and patterns, and design your entire website in the full site editor with your own templates, menus, and custom global colors. Very good, so now let me show you this in action. Okay guys, so if you want to try it out, there's a free version here. As you can see, Gutenkit, a page builder blocks pattern and templates for Gutenberg block editor. So this is the one here, okay, so you can download it from here or install it directly from the WordPress repo in your backend. And there's a paid version, which is the one we're going to use today. So let's address the price. Let me show you. So as you can see, there's a special offer at the moment. So here, the early bird personal, instead of $149, it's only $59 now. So this one third of the price almost there, you know. So this is available for 5 different sites, and you get lifetime updates and support. And for this, you'll also get access to all of these, obviously, you know. On top of this, you have this one here, the early bird exclusive. So instead of $249, it's $89. You can use this on 10 different websites. And now if you run a web agency or something like this, maybe this one would be more advantageous for you. Instead of $499, it's $179, and you get to use this on unlimited websites. So it's a small investment. And then in the end, you can build as many websites as you want. So as you can see right here, you get 500 plus ready templates, one page scroll, parallax effect, advanced accordion, header footer blocks. We're going to discover all these in a minute anyways, you know. So all these are included for that price. And again, this is the most popular plan. And now we can go to our pages. And I'm going to show you how easily you can build a website. So let's add maybe a homepage to start with. Okay, so add new page. And let's give it a title. So like we said, homepage. Okay, so publish, publish. And then let's start editing our page. And the first very handy feature with Gutenkit is actually the containers. So if you click on the plus sign here, this is the very first one that will show up. As you can see, this is under Gutenkit, and these are all basically the blocks that you can use to build your page. You can see loads of them here. So you can definitely design a lovely page very quickly as well, without too much hassle. Now again, usually with Gutenberg, it's very hard to actually create spaces here and fill them up with items. So if you use a container here immediately, this will solve the problem. So if you click on this, as you can select among a few different options. So full width, 50-50, one-third, two-third, two-third, one-third, three-thirds, and maybe 25, 50, 25. So that's really up to you. So let's say we were to create maybe a hero section and divide that in half. So all you have to do is click on this, so 50-50, okay? And there you go. Now we have our two containers here, and you can start adding your blocks inside them, obviously, you know? So as you can see, if you click on this, you have your main container, okay? But you also have your inner container as well. So if I click on this one, this is the inner container. This is the outer container, so the parent block, basically, okay? Just outside like this. And by the side, obviously, if you go to blocks, and from here, you can customize every aspect of your container. So you have everything related to the layout. So here, do you want to set it as full width, boxed, or custom? So a specific width, you know? Or maybe for the inside of the container as well, the content itself, do you want it to be full width or boxed? And then you can set the minimum height. So maybe let's say 53 in VH, but you could have it in pixels as well. So maybe you want 420 pixel in height, and then the content can be centered right in the middle, exactly the way you want, using flexbox container. So this is one very handy aspect of Gutenkit, to be honest, you know. And then you have the item properties here. So again, like we said, this is flexbox container. So which direction do you want to take? Row horizontal, like we have now. So from here to that side, maybe top to bottom. So this is basically one on top of each other, left to right, or bottom to top, you know. So usually it should be this one. And then set how you want to justify the content and align the item inside your container. So at the minute it's centered in the middle, but it could be on top, could be bottom or stretched out all together. So again, these are all Flexbox container properties that you can configure very easily from here. And obviously you can stylize every aspect of it as well. So if you go to style now, you can set your background, you have the background overlay and also your borders. Now when it comes to the user interface, I really like the icons they have. They're all very unique. As you can see, you've never seen them before. They've basically designed their own set of icons, you know, all of them, they're very unique. Even if you go here, as you can see, all of that, I've never seen them before, you know, and I really like that because that means they put a lot of effort into designing something that's very unique, a very lovely solution, as you can see, with all these different features. Okay, so let's move on to the next step now. So perhaps I can show you how to design your hero section here. And obviously the principle will apply throughout the whole website. I'm going to show you how easy you can build a website using Gutenkit. So as you can see by the side, you have your styling and you go to your background type. And let's add an image maybe as an example here. Okay, so let's click on the plus sign. I'm going to select an image. So I found one online here. So select and open. And then I'm going to add this to our background. Okay, so as you can see, it's loading up. There it is. And then you can change the position as well. So you have center, or you can have it custom as well. In which case, you can basically position it exactly where you want it. As you can see, absolutely amazing, isn't it? Super handy, super easy. And if you didn't have Gutenkit, well, that would be actually very difficult to achieve that using the block editor. So again, very handy feature indeed. And you have all sort of additional features as well, you know, attachment repeat or display size. So it could be cover, it could be contain, auto or custom. So I think cover should normally be the best option here because you can see the whole setup, and then you can add your heading here and maybe a call to action button. And if you don't have enough contrast between the text and the background, you can also enable the background overlay and set this up here. And you can even set the overlay in normal mode and hover mode. So this is pretty unique. I haven't seen that before, to be honest, you know. So quite handy indeed. So this is one way of doing it. So you can do it manually, step by step, using all their different blocks here. As you can see, quite a lot, I believe 85 of them in total, you know. So very handy indeed. So this is one way of doing it. So what I'm going to do is just delete this for now, and I'm going to show you another way of doing it, which is much easier and also way faster. And for this, we're going to use the template library. So simply click on this button here, and now you have access to 448 ready-made patterns that you can use and insert on your web page. As you can see, they're all broken down here by this different type of usage and different types of sections you might want to build. So you have business hours, call to action, a countdown timer. So let's have a quick look at this one maybe. As you can see, if you're running a special offer, maybe you can insert this on your homepage. And you have all these different layouts. And if you were to build any of those yourself, this would take quite some time, you know. Whereas here, all you have to do is basically click on it and import it, and it will be added to your page. And if you scroll down, as you can see, there's quite a few here. Your footer section as well, your header, Google Maps, your heading, image box, and so on and so on. As you can see, a large selection of different sections that you can insert directly on your page. And then some of them are quite unique and quirky as well. As you can see, you have WhatsApp here. I haven't seen that yet, apart from here, you know. As you can see, WhatsApp style, and basically we'll show like a speech bubble, like you're having a conversation on WhatsApp, and you took a screenshot and sharing it on the website, which I think is absolutely amazing. Not only have they created blocks that you can use, but they're also very unique and very modern looking. This is something I really like. So this is one way, one approach you can do so, using all these different patterns here, insert them on your page, and again 448, and they keep adding continuously. Or you can use ready-made templates. So this is slightly different. These are called template kits. And right here, as you can see, this one is the agency portfolio. It's only one page. This one, digital marketing, ready to go, ready-made, 7 pages. This one, 9 pages. So if you import this, basically your whole website is created for you using the block editor and all these beautiful blocks here and beautiful features. For restaurant here, as you can see, 4 pages. This one is 8 pages and 8 pages. So if you wanted to create a website very quickly, all you have to do is to import the template here. It will create that automatically for you, and all you have to do is to tweak things here and there, and that's basically it, and personalize it based on your client's requirements. Okay, or you can use pages as well. And again, here, same principle as the templates, except these are single pages, obviously, you know, and some of them are very unique, like this one here, the one page scroll. So let me show you here in the demo website. What I'm going to do is basically keep scrolling down the page, and you will see there is added effect to it as well. It will stop automatically, as you can see, it will bump from one section to the other. and it's the same on the way back up, you know. So if I go back up now, as you can see, boing, boing, as you can see, it's going to stop each every page and give you that lovely side sliding effect. And you can go from one page to the other immediately here using those dots. I think this is actually very professional looking. Or you can use internal pages as you see fit as well. So if you scroll down, as you can see, you have a home page here. This one is the pricing page, contact page. And as you can see, those are related to the same layout, and you have the same here for restaurants. So basically it's the same as templates, but these are all the internal pages. So if I only needed, let's say, homepage, maybe a contact page and about us, well, that's basically what I'm going to do. Okay. So let me show you here with the homepage. So I'm just going to import this one, click on that. And there you have it. As you can see, in just a few seconds, everything's been imported for us. So right here with the hero section, create a solution here. So this is maybe our different services, accomplishments, about us. What do we have here? Featured work as well. As you can see, this is very modern looking as well, you know. And all you have to do is to customize this as you see fit and based on your own requirements or maybe your client's requirements, obviously, you know. So let's go back to the top here, have a quick look, you know. So we have the hero section. How can you edit this? Very simply, click on it, and then you can change the content here. And all these are different blocks, obviously, right here by the side, using the Gutenkit heading block here, but all of them, obviously, from Gutenkit. So if I click on this, as you can see, this is an image, but this is advanced image. Again, this is a proprietary solution from Gutenkit themselves, you know, that they've designed specifically for this solution here. And then all you have to do basically is go through all the different items on your page, click on them, customize them here by the side and follow all these steps. That's basically it. So again, very simple, very user-friendly and also packed with features. Okay, now let me show you how you can insert dynamic content directly into your pages or blog posts. So again, this will work for blog posts and pages as well. So let's create a page together, add a new page, and let's call this one maybe dynamic page. Okay, so I'm going to publish, publish. Very good. And now we can add our blocks. So click on the plus side and let's add maybe a heading. Okay. And right here, as you can see, if you click on it, you have this icon here. So this is basically to import dynamic content. So if you click on this, you can now select the source, so either WordPress core or advanced custom field. So either of those will work fine. Okay. So let's go with the WordPress core. And here you can select any type of field that you want to import. As you can see, post custom field, post date, excerpt, ID, etc., etc. And also the tagline of the website, maybe the title, the current time and date, and also the author name, author info, and so on. Okay, so let's insert maybe the author name here and then click save data. And now we can update and have a quick preview, see what it looks like in the front end. And as you can see, my name was added dynamically. Okay, so now let me demonstrate the query builder, which is another amazing feature. So let's create a page together. And let's give it a title. So this one will be called Gutenkit Query Builder. Okay, so let's publish, publish again. And now let's add the query builder. So for this, we go to our blocks here, scroll down the page, and you will find the query builder here at the bottom. Okay, so let's add this. And with the query builder, you have two different options. You can choose a predefined template for the query loop, or you can start from blank. So what we're going to do here is start from blank, so you can see all the steps start to finish. Okay, so start from blank. And now you can select the layout that you want to apply to your query builder. So as you can see, a floating category, image, title, author, and comment. This one is the most comprehensive one. You have everything basically, you know, floating category, image, author, comments, title, and excerpt. So let's take this one as an example. Okay, so I'm going to add this one together here. Excellent. And as you can see, now it's displaying the content of our blog post. But this would work also for products or anything. As you can see here, from blog post to product listing, query builder loop, great, streamlines content, organization, and presentation. So this will work for any type of content on your website. And now let me show you how easily you can customize the layout and the outcome on your page. So let's click on one of those items here. As you can see by the side, this is a different block, and it will all be added like this as a loop, obviously, and fetch all the similar content like blog posts and display them in a very nice manner. So here by the side, as you can see, you can change the metadata. So basically at the moment we have author and comments. As you can see, this is the one here, this is the author, this is the comment, and now you can add any item that you want. So let's add an item together here. So it could be the date, or maybe the time, maybe the terms, or a custom field all together. So if it was a custom field, you can type whatever you want here, obviously, you know, and you can even have your own icon. So let's select a custom icon even here. So let's click on this, and we can scroll down the page, and let's add maybe the apple here. Okay, so insert, and I'm going to change this and type maybe apple here as an an example. So this is how far you can go into the customization process. So let's add together maybe the time when it was created. And here we can select maybe a clock, you know. So I'm going to select clock or time. This is the one here, insert. And there you go. As you can see, this looks fantastic already. But obviously you can stylize everything as well. So if you go into style here, as you can see, these are a bit too close to each other. Maybe you want to add a little bit of gap, a bit of breathing space, obviously, you know. So we can do that very easily. Right here, as you can see, space between. So we can increase that a little bit, maybe just like that, okay. Maybe 30. And then you can customize the text, the size, the colors, the size of your icons and all that. As you can see, icon and text, expand this. And look at this, guys. You have all the options that you want. If you want to change the size of your font, you go to typography and then it will open up an extra set of options here. So absolutely amazing. So let's change the size of the font together here as an example. So maybe you can reduce that maybe to 12 or 13, you know. And as you can see, that looks absolutely amazing already. Now you can change literally everything, you know, letter spacing, word spacing, you can transform the text and so on and so on. So you can really design the layout exactly the way you want, thanks to the query builder. And then obviously this will apply to all the different blocks here. So if you click on the image here, you can select the size, the alignment, or if you want to add caption or not, where do you want to link this directly to blog post, custom URL or media file, you know. So all of this is well thought out, guys. And again, you can design the exact layout that you want thanks to the query loop builder. So this is when you start from blank, but you can also use pre-made templates. So as you can see here, we have grid style 1 and grid style 2. So that's really up to you. You know, if you want to save a bit of time, you can use the pre-made template and this will be imported immediately into your website and look amazing. And finally, let me show you a few very unique blocks I've never seen before. It's only with them. So basically, if you go to Gutenkit blocks, you can see them all. And if you hover on top, as you can see, you can have a live demo immediately here to see what it looks like. And the first one I wanted to show you is the jewel button, as you can see here, live demo. Let's click on this and let me show you what it does. So basically, normally a button is a button, but here's double buttons. You have this one or this one, two options, this or that, okay. And this is very handy, especially if you have login, registration or this type of scenario. So I thought this one is quite unique. So the next one I wanted to show you is the business hours. If you click on the live demo again, this is what it looks like. So if you scroll down, as you can see, you have Saturday and Sunday close maybe, and then the opening hours during the week. So again, this is very handy as well. And then the next one I wanted to show you is the WhatsApp message. So if you click on the live demo again, this is what it looks like. So you can display a customized button and connect WhatsApp through a pop-up. So this is very handy. Obviously, everyone is on WhatsApp nowadays. So if you want your visitors to get in touch with you, you can do that using WhatsApp immediately. As you can see, you have different layouts and it's very, very handy indeed. All you have to do is to type their message and they can send it directly to you and you'll be chatting with them immediately. So there you go, guys. As you can see, Gutenkit is quite an impressive tool that will allow you to design website exactly the way you want in Gutenberg. Now, if you'd like to give it a go, as always, I'll leave all links in the description below. Thanks for watching and I'll catch you in the next one.